Alistair.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, given the undeniable seriousness of this issue and the potential devastating consequences for our entire agri-food industry and more, it's a huge disappointment to me that when the DUP had the leverage, they squandered it and instead returned to this House without this issue being resolved. Mr. Buckley referred to it as a time bomb. The opportunity to insist on the defusing of the time bomb was before you give up your leverage. And it is a disappointment that other things mattered more than our farming community. And those who present themselves as the friends of the farmers let down the farmers in sacrificing that issue. And what did they get? Well, what maybe turns out to be a talking shop, who knows? And the promise of legislation on the never and ever. And for that, we continue to live under the cloud and the threat of devastation arising from the withdrawal of veterinary medicines. And it really, as far as the EU side is concerned, is a nonsense. Because throughout the grace period, since we left the EU, has there been a single threat posed by the veterinary medicines we're using to their single market or to animal health? No. And yet they say, we cannot continue to use the very medicines which aren't causing a problem. That is a typical EU triumph of dogma over reality, with a punitive tinge, which is often there when it comes to how the EU deals with matters. They know, as we know, that pharmaceutical companies are now forward planning, that they are deciding what they will and won't produce for where, and yet they hang back, refused to arrive at an arrangement to solve a problem that isn't a problem for them, but is a mammoth problem for Northern Ireland and its agri-food industry. And within that, I find echoes of the most punitive and the most belligerent of responses, which don't surprise me, because we've had them before, from the EU. And so here we are, our traditional path of medicines from GB, 85% of them come from there. Not one of them has inflicted any damage, any hurt, anywhere in the EU, on animals or on health, and yet with that proven track record of non-damage, the EU belligerently refuses to do the decent thing. They could have done this when they made concessions about human medicines, but they held out on this, refusing quite deliberately to deal with this issue. And that speaks not to the goodwill, not to the benevolence, but to the belligerence of the EU and its attitude towards Northern Ireland. All the more shame why, and this of course is the root of the problem, all the more shame that Northern Ireland was betrayed under a protocol and left subject to EU law and EU veterinary medicines agency and all the rest of it. And now we're paying the price, a price which is only there to extract pain and discomfort and to serve no purpose. No animal health purpose at all is being served by this approach by the EU. So shame on them, though no surprise.